live my day. To make you say dad, cause I'm getting my way. It's my time to
Hello, everyone, and welcome to 2K Sports. I'm Damon Bruce. A Tuesday night NBA presentation. It's Tony Parker and the San Antonio Spurs going up against Gerald Wallace and the Portland Trailblazers. Let's send things over to Kevin Harlan, who's in Portland for today's broadcast.
Sports welcomes you to the NBA with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. We're glad you're aboard. The Portland Trailblazers come into tonight's game after losing earlier in the season in their last game against San Antonio. A look at the San Antonio Spurs opening lineup. Parker and Manu are the backcourt. Blair and Duncan down low. And it's Jefferson in at the small forward position. And for the Trailblazers, Aldridge and Camby up front. Felton is out there with Matthews. And it's Wallace in at small forward. And it's going to be the Trailblazers off the tip. So the opening lineup for the Spurs, presented by State Farm. Manu and Jefferson on the wings. Blair and Duncan down low. And it's Parker in at the point guard position. Felton. Rebound San Antonio. They put up a nice win against Utah last time out.
Well, they were fortunate to be up against a D that looked totally overmatched. I mean, there wasn't much that they couldn't do offensively.
Yeah, they completely had their way with
it. Goes up to the stripe. Gets the bucket. Ginobili's got the game going with his first points of the game for the Spurs. Now, here's Felton. 9 points, last game out. Back to Camby. 6 on the shot clock. 3-pointer. Dwan Blair grabs the... Felton the pass to Aldridge. Back and down. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line. No good, and that's
just awful. It started out slowly. It seemed like it just spread through the whole team. Nobody could make a shot.
And people lost confidence, too. I mean, that's what jumped out at me, Steve. The ball became kind of a hot potato. Nobody wanted to take the next shot.
Here is Parker. The Blazers getting the bucket over Felton. And that one's good. Blair comes in for Splitter. And Gary Neal subbed in for Tony Parker. Now here's Ginobili. Averaging 12 points a game from down low, and he lays it up and in. Wallace against Jefferson. That's good from Wallace on the assist by Felton. Manu Ginobili on the wing, guarded by Crawford. Over Thomas, and Manu Ginobili again. Wallace over Green. This is off the left iron. Over Crawford, and he drains it.
That builds a little momentum going into the next quarter.
Yeah, you know, you definitely have to make sure you take advantage of that last possession. You don't want to squander that.
And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. Spurs lead by 4.
And it's really been a dominant effort on the glass. That's been the key here.
Yeah, they've established.
Untapped this Wednesday. Andre Iguodala and the Philadelphia 76ers go up against Kevin Martin and the Houston Rockets. Live from Houston. Be there.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up.
But that one definitely looked like a block to me.
Ginobili the pass to Green. Ginobili. 6 to shoot. Over Aldridge. Nice shot by Ginobili. Ginobili's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Spurs. Parker against Crawford. Puts the lead pass in front of him. And Aldridge slams it in.
He put that
by Green.
Well, he was being overly optimistic there, thinking he could make.
Ginobili right side. And he uses the glass on the layup. Goes up on the block. Gets it to go. He has six here. Back in a moment, live from.
Happy Tuesday to you, and welcome to HP at the Half. The Spurs have been rolling along. They've played gritty D and have been hauling in the defensive rebounds. Some nice plays so far from Tony Parker. Manu Ginobili, also been a big contributor. And battling nonstop, the Portland Trailblazers. They're trying to close in on the eighth best record in the conference. A win here would give it to them. LaMarcus Aldridge, a big impact in this one. They aren't exactly eye-catching numbers, but don't be fooled. He's came to play, and he's leading them towards a victory in this one. And now, here's some of the stats from tonight's two top performers. Looking in on more games scheduled for later tonight, real scores and real stats from the real NBA. Over at Quicken Loans Arena, the Cavaliers will face off against the Pistons. Nothing like a divisional matchup. 7 p.m. Eastern tip time. And one game also on the docket, the Hornets face off against the Pacers in Indianapolis. That one gets going at 7 p.m. Eastern. And a look here at the other action around the association. Out in Memphis, it'll be the Grizzlies.
Back to Wallace. A baseline J. That's good, and so Felton has the assist there. Felton's got three assists tonight. Now Ginobili. He's got 12. Fires from 14. And that one's good. Parker. Jefferson kicks to Leonard. Just five on the clock. The Spurs need to get a shot off here. Let's it go. The turnaround jumper. Count it. Here's Neal. Parker outside. Five to shoot. Over Felton. And that one's good.
Gets the lead, and then the other one's going right back.
Yeah, that is evidenced by the eight lead changes we've seen so far.
And at the close of the third quarter, still a close game, and both teams putting up points in a hurry. And it's more NBA action coming your way here on 2K Sports.
Rajon Rondo and the Boston Celtics go up against Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder. Don't miss it.
And now our sideline reporter, Doris Burke, has a report for our Sprite Spark of the game. Doris?
Hey, Kevin. Well, our Spark of the game goes to the Spurs for that major surge. They came out of the gates with an airtight defense, and that is what pushed them out in front. If they end the game how they started, they'll come away with the win, Kevin.
Great stuff as always, Doris. Thank you, Clark. That was the game's critical point.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I really think it was. I mean, it really tipped things in their favor. No doubt about it.
Now, that's going to happen to you when you keep piling up those points and you get on a run like that.
They've got Batum. Craig Smith is out there with Campbell. Then there's Felton, and it's Crawford at the two spot. That's the group in the game for the Trailblazers. Smith left side. Tries a three. A rebound by the Spurs. Here's the break. Now here's Ginobili. Rebound by Smith. Outside, Felton. He's picked up by Parker. On the wing, Jamal Crawford. Launches a three, and Ginobili pulls it down.
Can really turn on small details and one or two plays.
That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Stolen by Thomas.
Well, that was a great steal, preventing what may have been an easy hoop.
Floats one up. That's good. 16 points for Ginobili.
That just shows you guys. I mean, he's always in aggressive mode. I mean, he will exploit any opening the defense gives him. And he's always probing, looking for opportunities to attack.
And here's Crawford. Six on the shot clock. Aldridge backing in. The shot. Aldridge can't get that one to fall.
He's laboring out there right now, guys. The shot has not been falling for him this quarter.
Less than 1 minute left. Wallace against Ginobili. Shot clock at six. Over Wallace. Manu Ginobili again. Ginobili outside. Four on the clock. Let's the three fly. That's good. And it's a 10-point Spurs lead.
I think that may do it here. They're trying to put the nail in the coffin.
Well, just adding to the lead as we approach the final buzzer.
And so it's San Antonio with the win. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. Well, that'll do it. For Doris Burke, Steve Curry, Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying so long, we'll see you next time. And as we leave, we give you our Jordan Player of the Game, Manu Ginobili.